Welcome again to Electrical Engineering 3300 at the University of Utah. Today we're going to be talking about the transmission line or telegrapher's equations. These equations are used to derive the voltage and the current as a function of time on a transmission line. We're going to derive one equation for voltage and another equation for current, and we're going to be using both of them throughout the semester to derive how the fields propagate on a transmission line. We're going to begin with a standard RLGC model. This is the resistor, here is the inductor, right here is the conductance, and here's the capacitance. This R prime is the resistance per unit meter, per unit length. L prime is in Henry's per meter, G prime is in Mohs per meter, and C prime is in farads per meter. This little piece of line is a small length, let's call it delta Z long. Maybe that's a millimeter, maybe that's a meter. It's a very small piece of a transmission line. One of the questions that came up in class last time is, why do I need to use multiple copies of this RLGC in order to build up an entire transmission line? And let's kind of take a look at that question. Right here is the transmission line. We're going to put the positive voltage on the top conductor. We're going to ground the bottom conductor. And what's going to happen is the wave is going to propagate down this transmission line. The way the wave propagates is by resonating between the inductor and the capacitor on this transmission line. So we need a model that represents inductance and capacitance. That's a resonance circuit right there. And it's going to pass the resonance on to the next inductor and capacitor, and the next inductor and capacitor, and so on. The resistor and the conductance and the various resistors and conductance along here represent the loss in the circuit. All they do is attenuate the wave. So we're going to begin with this RLGC circuit, which is a resonant circuit that describes the propagation on the transmission line. Let's just go draw that again so that we've got kind of a clean slate. Here's the resistor, inductor, conductance, capacitance. There's our little piece of transmission line, and it is of length delta Z. Now let's see where the voltages and the currents are within this transmission line piece. Right here, we're going to call this point Z, and this point right here is going to be Z plus delta Z. So right at this place, we have the voltage at location Z, and on this side, we're going to have the voltage at location Z plus delta Z. Now let's draw the currents. We're going to have one current right here that we're going to call I of Z, and the output current is going to be I of Z plus delta Z, and then we're going to have a current going through the conductance and a current going through the capacitance. So let's call that I of G and I of C. Now that what we're going to do is write two sets of equations. One of them is going to be the loop equation and the other is going to be a node equation. So here's the loop equation that I'm going to write. Now remember, what we do is we start with our voltage and we add up all of the voltages in a circle, and of course they need to add up to be zero. So we're going to begin right here. V of Z plus R times the current at Z minus, oops, I'm sorry, that's not a plus, that's a minus. V of Z minus the resistance times the current minus L di dt, and that's at location Z, minus V of Z plus delta Z is equal to zero. Now the other thing that I want to note is that all of these variables, this voltage, this current, this derivative, and this voltage, are all functions of time. So we could equally well write V of Z plus delta Z and T, but just for simplicity, I'm going to leave this part out of the equation as I am writing it. And let's remember some important factors here. R, which is the resistance in ohms, is equal to R prime, which is given in ohms per meter, times delta Z. And L, which is given in Henry's, is L prime, which is Henry's per meter, times delta Z, and so forth. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this entire equation and I'm going to multiply it by 1 over delta Z.